Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and today I'm going to walk you through how to set up Tensorflow for a Mac with the M1 processor. The M1 processor has a lot of exciting things happening, including the new upcoming Studio, which has 64 cores at its peak. So it's a good time to get familiar with this process, and it's only going to take a few minutes. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a look at how to use pluggable devices with Tensorflow. In this case, we're going to use the M1 Mac ecosystem. And if I go ahead and I take a look at that, you can see that there is a new way of using the Mac's powerful GPUs to train Tensorflow models. And in this guide here, you can see the information. Currently, though, there isn't multi-GPU support, but there is support for GPUs in Macs. And there's a set of instructions here that walks you through how to do it. In a nutshell, you have to go through and install Conda. That's really the first step here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you, I've already got this set up inside of a repo called Noah Gift, Tensorflow M1 setup. And I've actually gone through here and enumerated what to do. Make sure you have homebrew, Xcode, install, miniforge. Afterwards, go ahead and source a environment. And then at this point, there's a few different installs here. There's Tensorflow Depths, there's Tensorflow Mac OS, and Tensorflow Metal. Now, if I go to this makefile, after you've got Conda installed and sourced it, you can just go ahead and run this, and this will install probably the libraries that you would want. Now, to verify it is working, all you have to do is go ahead and run Juypter Notebook. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to bring over a terminal right here, and I've got this set up. I'm going to type in Juypter Notebook, and if we go ahead and launch this up, it's going to launch a Juypter Notebook environment for me. And if I go ahead and I select this, what's nice about this is it's going to show me the whole environment so that I can test it out in this notebook. And additionally, one of the things that we can do is I can move over this GPU graph here that should show me how much GPU is being utilized by the Apple M1 Max. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to say kernel, restart, and run all. And notice I've even got some times in here to time it. Let's go ahead and do that. And you can see here that it is now going through and training the model. And in a second, we should see that, in fact, this is the case, that the GPU is becoming fully saturated from the training process from TensorFlow. And this is really one of the great things about a Mac is that it has very good instrumentation to take a look at what's happening in your system. And the GPU history is actually an excellent one. You can also look at the activity monitor if I fit this over here as well. And you can see that in fact, Python is taking 135% CPU and it shows you the CPU time and it also shows you GPU time of 8%. So it's not fully using all of it, but it's using a decent amount. And then finally, if we go down here, you've seen that we're able to evaluate it. So in a nutshell, it's pretty straightforward to run TensorFlow using Mac M1.